already arrived in the high speed train station Kereta Cepat Indonesia. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to start my Wireshark in this case. But if I lay down and I play dead and I stay dead, maybe you'll get sick of being the monster out of my head under my bed. Hello guys, welcome to Rifki the Cyber. If you see, I already pack my bag and I also prepare my tripod in this case. Why? Because we are going to go to the high-speed railway of the first in the Southeast Asia, the first the high-speed railway. To be exact, is Indonesia. Well, as of as I record this video, guys. It's connecting two major cities between Jakarta to Bandung. And is already in the plan going to roll out in others major cities in this case. High-speed railway is adopting the GSM railway technology for the communications purpose in this case. Since the learning is very fun part, what we're gonna do is we are going to the high-speed railway stations right now. We will go to the stations, we will observe the stations itself, we will observe the platform of the train, and of course, we will not miss this part. We are going to scan the GSM railway signaling system and we will like to try to see what is the message is being sent and being broadcasted. And we will reflect it and visualize it in the Majestic Protocol Analyzer that we call it, the name is Wireshark. They're using the band of the GSMR. That is the band frequency, the GSMR itself. So we are going to scan there, guys. I would like to apologize because I'm not using my microphone this one. I'm going to use my mini microphone, so the quiet of the sounds is quite a bit challenged. But I try my best when I'm editing later to make the quality of the sound is still very clear. It won't avoid us to learn the quality of the learning itself. Do they have IMSIs? What are the messages that we notice is being broadcast more rather than the GSM cellular in the GSM railway? We about to find out, guys. So let's go, guys, rather than a lot of chatty. Hey guys, I already arrived in the high speed train station Kereta Cepat Indonesia. And if you can see from here, we need to put our luggage there in the machines. There's a conveyor belt to check whatever the x-ray, to check whatever is the inside of our bag. So before the sniffing, we will pass through this one and then we will start to get the GSM railway signaling system after that. Okay guys. Okay, currently I already set up my bag etc. here and I'm exactly below the platform. So the above is the platform of the high-speed train of Indonesian high-speed train, and they implement the GSM railway in this case. So today I'm just trying to see and just want to see what you call this, what is the BTS message that being broadcasted in the GSM railway signaling system in this case. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to use this one, the NX SDR. Although I know that the GSM railway is actually is in the band 900. So I'm going to plug this. And now I'm going to running the scanning of scanner, GRGSM scanner for this band, GSM railway. So what I'm gonna do, so this is the command, GRGSM scanner, band GSM railway. So if we do like this, for example, we can get a lot of GSM band here. So what I'm going to choose the GSM railway in this case. So let's start, guys. I'm just going to clear this and then I'm start scanning. Oh whoops, I forgot to, after plug the device, I need to enable this one. So I'm going to start the scanning now. Okay guys, this is the result. So we get this is RFCN number 6 with this 936.2 megahertz is found first. I think 22, if I'm not wrong, is not yet allocated in this, in the current, what you call this, in the current operator that already established. So I do believe this is maybe is the GSM railway itself, and also showing the strongest power also here in this. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to test with this frequency 936.2 megahertz in this case. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to start my Wireshark in this case. And I'm going to switch on the loopback. And this is the comment in this case. So I'm going to choose this. And then boom. Okay guys. We can see this is how we read how the broadcast of the GSM railway signaling system from their BTS to this current to my laptop. Now we can see what is the message of the GSM railway BTS that being broadcasted here, guys. So this is actually from the GSM railway BTS downlink towards to this laptop. We can see it directly from this one. So just make sure this is GSM tab. I will make sure that this is not mixed being in another things in this case. Everything almost remain the same. System information number 3, number 2, etc. And also there is some normal even also here. Okay guys, this is there are so many things here. There system information number 2, number 3, etc. And I noticed that there are something that really not really cover with the another BTS. For example, is using BTS using the system number, and they sometimes is not really utilize the notification. But I can see there are a lot of notifications operation here in this case. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going just to going to stop this one. See here the notifications, and we get also the immediate assignment. Everything is remain the same like others. Okay, we can find also there are some notifications here in this case. Also there are some immediate assignment, etc. What type of the immediate assignment here? There is a paging mode, they are using the same thing also here. Also they are using the channel. What is the channel description? Okay, they are using the SD, DTH. There are also locations area here. And of course this is because this is unknown, just mention unknown because it's allocated for the TSM railway itself, right guys? And also can we see some IMSI here as also? Let's check here. Okay. We got also some IMSI here, guys. Oh, okay, this is interesting. Okay, they are using unallocated also here, 09. Of course, the Luxia is not really necessary in this case. Because this is cooperation between Jakarta and China. We can see also there are some IMSI. It came also from the China MCC as well, 460 in this case. Hello guys, how's the learning? It's fun, right? My suggestion is, as I always say in my other previous video, keep learning and stay humble.